Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophinet and welcome back to XCOM 2 in our Commander playthrough. We're ready to go on Operation Gilded Hammer, where we're gonna rescue a scientist from the Advent Forces. So a difficult mission, so shouldn't be that hard. And we also get 116 intel if we are successful. So let's head into the firebrand, the Sky Ranger? Sky Ranger, that's it. Kinda lost the name there.
Ranger deployed.
There we go, Sky Ranger deployed. In position, here we go.
Advent is holding a VIP of some value to the Resistance, and the spokesman has asked us to move in and attempt a rescue operation. We're expecting heavy resistance at the site, and the aliens have had extensive air support moving in that region that'll keep Firebrand grounded. Lock down the area, eliminate all hostile contacts, and secure the VIP.
It said that we couldn't get the entire supply drop, because otherwise we would have been able to upgrade our weapons to, the few normal assault rifles that are in the bunch to from magnetic to plasma rifles. But yeah, it's only one guy, so it's not gonna make that much of a difference. Dropping down on what seems to be a building. So yeah, we're on higher ground immediately.
Menace 1-5, we have a confirmed location for the VIP. Move to rendezvous. Eliminate all hostile contacts.
Seems like it's doable since we start in concealment, so I'm just gonna start putting everybody up. And I guess I'll see you guys. You have been seeing this for a while now, so I'm guessing I'm just gonna see you guys when we get first action. Oh, and I think, yeah. There we go. That's pretty heavy. Shield bearer, an archon, and something else that I can't really see right now. Let's take a look. A normal trooper, not as much. So I'm guessing we're just gonna move everybody to that side if we can. So that's gonna have to wait until next turn. But for now, just get everybody in position.
Closing on target position now.
And that's it, I think. Okay, so let's move everybody closer towards the enemies over there. Might actually even move them completely towards the other edge if I can. Just gonna use Jazz as a sort of... Ooh. Okay, so over there is actually already in sight. Which is interesting, because I can't see the trooper. So that shouldn't trigger any of them. Otherwise, I'm gonna be fucked immediately, but at least we got a bit of ground that we covered. No, it doesn't trigger anything, which is good.
Moving.
Christophe, let's go over here with you.
Understood. Moving out.
Let's put Ulrich over here next to Jazz. Should be safe over there. And then Benito over here. And can I actually use the grapple for something? No. So I'm just going to move him up completely over here. And then overwatch with the ones that are left, I suppose. Maybe move up Yang a bit as well. Couldn't hurt. There we go. Because we need to move as fast as we can, since we're at a timer again. And we need to extract everybody if we can. So let's see. I'm just going to use Ulrich. What can you do with a single grenade? I think you can blow up the car along with the trooper, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, let's try something like this. It's a nice start. It immediately shreds the shield bearer's armor. Although I might actually wait off with that, because grenades, I always do that. I start out with a grenade, but that's actually not that great of a tactic, since you, well, one, lose a grenade, and the shots get harder since they go into cover, and grenades don't really have a percentage chance that they hit. So let's just try and take out... Well, why not? Let's just try and take out a bit of the Archon's health with Benito. And that marks him as well, so that was the double intention there. So now all the shots at the Archon should be boosted by 15%, I think. Hello, Mr. Archon. Are you a bit mad? Oh. That is interesting. So they just moved down. What I'm going to do is, we have Vinny to start with. So let's use his lightning hands shot to get the boosts on those Yeah, the boost on those shots are really nice. Because of the aim percentages, 3 damage is not much, of course, but we could take him out here, I think. And if we can, that would be very nice. Do we have... Looks like we have... what's that ability called? Quick draw. Firing your pistol with your first action no longer ends your turn. So technically, we should be able to fire just twice with Vinny with the pistol. So for that reason, I'm just going to move Jazz down over here. I think I can. Yeah, that should be full cover. Hopefully there's nothing in the building. Otherwise, I'm going to have a lot more enemies on my hands. But let's just drop you down. That is very high. I don't know how they survived that, but they do. Now we have a flank shot on the trooper. Hopefully a crit, because that's apparently not... Yeah, okay. Goodbye.
12 damage in the bag.
Okay. And a promotion for Jazz. Thank you very much. Christoph, I'm just going to save you for now. Because you're always handier if we... save you for last, or we can scout with you at least. Just gonna have to see that I hit both the shield bear and the Archon. So I think this will kill the shield bear, since the grenade will blow up the car as well, if I'm not mistaken. So let's try that. Boom. Blammo. And giant explosion. So that extra XP, yeah, there we go. Thank you, Shield Bear. Goodbye. And then the double pistol shot. I'm just gonna double tap you. Fire pistol, 2 times 100% might actually kill him now. There we go, goodbye. That marking, I really need to use that more often. Just use Benito on the first shot and just take advantage of that. I can actually grapple further if I want to. I'm just gonna use Christoph as a scout as usual. And see what else lies ahead. Because I think we're pretty close, yeah. So this is the building that we need to enter. And I think the door is over here, yeah. The door is over here on the right. So we need to enter over there. Because there's not really an entryway. Well, that might be a door. That's a bit out of the way. Because we need to just move in a straight line as much as we can. We still have 10 turns. So 9 turns, actually. Because we're, of course, at the 10th turn.
Moving to designated position.
Let's move Christoph down, again, without breaking his ankles, apparently. And let's see. Yeah, there we go. Ooh, is that a turret or what is that? 3 armor. What is that? Oh. Is it that time already? So those are advanced mechs. So 3 armor and a buttload of health. I'm not even going to check what that is. But we're equipped to handle that, so that's not that bad. I can actually see the guys over there already. So if I keep behind this car, that should be fine, I think, because they're behind the building over there. So if I just keep behind the car, that should be fine. Over here.
On my way.
Oh, fuck you. How did you... Oh, the turret. Okay, never mind. Never mind. That's not that bad. Because the turret might have spotted her. Wait, what? How do you see... I'm not even going to ask that question. I'm just going to fire at it. Just because I can. This car exploded already, so I can't damage it even further. So, here we go. Missed, of course. God damn it. Okay, we have an active turret. I can't hit the turret from over here, and it's way too risky to start grappling to the next building. So I'm just gonna go on pistol overwatch, and then overwatch. I'm gonna get shot, probably. But it's... Oh wow, that's full cover, idiot. Seriously? Well, that was something. Vinny. I'm gonna have to save that as well, because now I'm gonna try and trigger the dudes over there as well.
Aucun problème.
So Jazz is gonna trigger them. Hopefully only them. There we go. I want to lure them out in the open a bit, or at least allow me to take care of that. Ooh. So the mech goes on Overwatch immediately. I could start lobbing grenades, but well, the building is in the way for a sniper shot, probably. Oh, yes it is. Yes it is. I can immediately take care of the turret, but the turret is in a perfect position to actually get hacked. Although I'm apparently one space shy of getting there. Shit. Getting into cover, at least. I'm gonna put him out in the open. I could, but it's really, really risky. I can actually... What the... What can I haywire? Oh! I can haywire protocol from over here. That's actually great. Can I only... Yeah, okay. I can try and haywire protocol the turret. We're gonna see what that does. Well, it's gonna take him over, hopefully. He doesn't even see... He's doing that in the wild. Okay, then. 56 to take temporary control of the turret. A failed hack will increase this target's aim and defense stats. I can take it out with a sniper rifle if I need to.
Fuck.
That was really close. Damn it. Could have been perfect. Could have been perfect, but never you mind. Just gonna take it out then. That's too bad, because I really wanted to use... So 99 is still pretty good, so let's take it out. 1, 2, 3. Goodbye. So that's at least the turret gone. And now I want to try... We still have a lot of grenades left. And the incendiary... Ooh, what can the incendiary do here? I think I'm just going to go for the plasma grenade. It's her last one already. But this is gonna be great if I can aim it correctly. I'm hoping this takes out the tower. It should. It's marking it as much. As such. And it should take care of the cover of the shield bear. Can I put it even further? There we go. That should do it, hopefully. So that at least does some damage to the mech, removes his overwatch. Here, catch. And yeah, we'll see what happens next. Yeah, there goes the officer. Wow, he was flopping all over the place. So 2 damage to the officer. Didn't he take more from the fall? Apparently not. I could... How much damage can I do with a sword attack? 6 to 8, so I can't even kill any of those. No. No. Don't even try it. So I think I'm going to have to go with the Mimic Beacon. I'm going to try the best I can, but I think I'm going to have to go with that. Let's see what we can do. So let's keep Jazz as last. Do I use the EMP grenade on that mech? I don't think we're going to get something bigger than that. So might as well use it on the mech. And maybe take it out in one go. Would be nice. So let's drop down Ulrich. Let's drop... No, wait a second. I'm just going to use Ulrich's grenade already. EMP bomb. 12 damage. It's not going to affect any of those guys, but just like the effect. Here we go. EMP. And boom. And that actually stuns. Hack defense decreased. Okay. So that's not even killing it. I'm going to try and use Kistoff to kill the officer with his high crit chance. And since that will probably fail, I'm just going to use the Mimic Beacon in our next turn. So let's just shotgun the hell out of this guy. I might actually kill him. Here we go. Goodbye. So that's still 2 enemies left, and I don't want to risk it.
Did you see that one?
I really don't want to risk it. So, Implacable? That actually makes him invincible as well, since he killed someone. But, the grenade will probably probably not be big enough. Yeah, nope. And I couldn't kill the shield bear even if I tried. So I'm just going to use the Mimic Beacon, put it behind cover over there, and just be done with it. And that should keep the fire from us. And I'm just going to move Christoph. Might actually move you over here to get a better shot next time.
Seems doable.
So, shield bear coming closer, firing at the Mimic Beacon. No biggie. And then the mech's probably gonna try the same thing. Unless he's... Okay, no. He's just gonna flank the Mimic Beacon. And look at that damage output of that mech. We don't want to get hit by that guy. So Mimic Beacon decoy was killed. But now we have all the time in the world to take him out. And we should have a clear path inside of the building. And there's the VIP. Yeah, okay. I was kind of looking for him. Jazz. I want to use Jazz. Can I use Jazz? I want to use Jazz. Jazz, let's put you over here. I'm a bit afraid of what lies further, but we don't really have another option here. Because the plan is I'm going to use Vinny. Maybe I'm going to do that immediately. I'm going to use Vinny to drop him down and just use a pistol shot to kill the mech. And this is not even going to kill. Wait a second. I think I'm going to just use Jazz's grenade. And blow up the wall the shield bear is hiding behind, and removing his armor as well. There we go. Little ammo. So that takes care of that. He's still behind half cover for some reason. Then I'm gonna use Vinny, his pistol shot, to kill the mech. There we go. Goodbye. 8 damage with a simple pistol. But of course, the blue screen runs do their job admirably. And then Christoph or Friar or anybody else who wants to try something. Just gonna move Benito closer as well, because we don't really have a choice on that account, because we need to get him closer. He's actually marked as flanked, but the shot percentage is really, really bad for some reason. I could try Yang Shot first, since she needs a promotion still. Just to spread out the experience a bit. 77% is the same as Ulrich's for some reason. And goodbye. And now we probably have one more pod left.
What did you expect?
That, exactly. I expected you to kill him. That is a problem as well, but... Ooh, this thing is on fire as well. Let's just put him over here.
Boss.
Take the loot, and hopefully not trigger anything else. A laser sight and an advanced hair trigger. Not that useful, but it's something at least.
I've got the thing.
The thing, yeah, you got the thing. So let's put him a bit closer.
Whatever you say.
Hopefully not triggering anything. No, okay. So that means we can put Ulrich a bit closer, maybe? Do want to be careful. We still have 8 turns, and he's the last one to move. So I'm just going to put him on Overwatch. Don't want to risk it one bit. So let's start moving everybody up again. I'm gonna keep Vinny for last. Probably gonna reload her, but then we need to hack the door, please.
Access on system.
And release that VIP. And of course we're gonna go for, because income from the current region increased by 25%. It's not even 25%, just 25. Is not that amazing, so I'm just gonna go for the soldier's hacking stat. Please, 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 please. Oh, fuck you. Yeah, my tech score is double the tech score of the door, but never mind giving me that nice loot.
Siamo dentro.
But it's open anyway. So let's open the door. That's closing the other door. There's too many doors. Let's open this door and then open. Nope. I'm too fast every single time. Luckily, that doesn't cost an action. There we go. Open that door.
The VIP is secure and we're on the move.
Are we on the move?
5 status confirmed. VIP is in tow. Proceed to the extraction point.
So now we can actually use the VIP. So I'm gonna try and get Ulrich closer. Although it's kind of risky.
I can handle that.
Because if there's something over there, I don't wanna antagonize it just yet. We still have 7 turns to get over there in the corner, so I think we're pretty good. I'm gonna put the VIP over here. And everybody else, some people I'm gonna reload and everybody else just on Overwatch. Maybe Benito, put him a bit closer. There we go. Hunker down. Overwatch. I can't because Benito, oh shit. But let's fire at the Vipers. 8 damage. Wow, that's an insta-kill. Thank you. Thank you, Ulrich. That's one less problem to deal with, but I think I saw an Archon. I saw an Archon. Yeah, there he is. Oh, wow. He's going up top. They're both going up top. That's 5 damage on the Archon already. That's really, really good. They're actually going a weird... It's a really weird position. No.
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
Okay. So the faster I can take out the Viper and the Archon, the faster I'm gonna be able to. Jesus Christ, this is harsh. All of a sudden. Kinda knew that because if you rescue the VIP, you get reinforcements every time. But what are your shots? 67 on the Viper, that's not really good. So I want to get on your level. But of course on a better position than that. Let's see what the other guys can do. Jazz might be able to just insta-kill the snake. I was saying snake, but... Slash on the Viper. So 6-8 damage. Might kill him, might not kill him as well. But it's 100%, so it's guaranteed damage. Let's just see. I'm gonna use Kristoff to get up there and give us a better position to see what the Archon is up to.
I can handle that.
There we go. So let's go up there. So the Archon is over there. Should I use another grenade? Because Ulrich still has one of his grenades. If I do that, I'm probably gonna destabilize this entire building and possibly kill Kristoff with it. So I'm gonna have to be careful with that. He's not gonna fall down immediately. I'm gonna keep that into account because that might end badly. But we can hit the Archon pretty solidly from over here without even touching the tile. I can even put that further. So even a bit to the left. Yeah, that's perfect actually. So that's good. So I think I'm gonna go with Jazz's Sword Slash as a start. And see what we can do from over there. So that's a good position. So let's go. I'm hoping he's gonna kill him immediately. Otherwise we have a few grenades left. That was a 15% chance for a critical and he just nailed it. Thank you. Thank you. That was really, really nice. 82 on the Archon. I think I'm gonna take that, because we have, if that hits, he's almost dead, and we have a few guaranteed damage dealers that could finish him off easily. So let's just do that. That was even a critical. 12 damage, so he's practically dead. If I can get line of sight with Benito, which I'm not gonna get, of course, maybe I could lob a grenade over there. How far can you throw that? Can you throw that into the face of the Archon? Oh, I can. Wow. That was an honest surprise. Just do that, because that's gonna kill it. Goodbye. Now there is a giant hole in the floor there, but at least everybody's dead. I mean, they are. Next up, I think I'm gonna put, because we still have that those reinforcements incoming, I'm gonna put Vinny over there with the grappling hook. I'm guessing there's no more enemies on the map. That's a dangerous guess I'm doing there, but I'm taking there. Ooh, this is actually pretty nice. Would I be able to overwatch from over here? That should be possible, right? That should be possible. So the VIP is pretty safe over here. She technically could stay in the building. Be escorted by Yang over here.
Absolutely.
Just in case anything is still in the building, which I really, really don't want to. And start moving everybody closer. Do have to be careful that I can actually perform some actions while inside of this building, because you might not be able to. No, I'm just going to boost Ulrich up as well, just so he can boost up to the window next turn and shoot from over there. Because we know where they're going to land, so that's something at least. I'm going to pistol overwatch, and that's it apparently. Reinforcements! Okay, trooper, officer, and shield bearer. Not that bad, actually. As they could have thrown in another advanced mech over here, but that's not happening. Is that that officer? It looks like he's kind of in the scenery, but no. Okay. Pistol? Yeah, there we go. In the officer's face. Blammo! That was a tree, Vinny. That was a tree. Why did you hit the tree?
Negative damage.
Yeah, that was a tree. You blew up a tree. Okay. It doesn't look like we can hit. Or can we? What is happening? Oh shit, yeah, Jazz fell down. Well, that's something I thought that was gonna happen. Okay, we have a bit of options with Kistoff, who can flank two out of the three guys. I'm gonna have to focus my efforts on some of these other troopers. Yang, how far can you go? We can go through the door, because those guys apparently didn't think about the door. And I still have an incendiary grenade as well. So if I play this right, they can actually just die. I'm gonna put Yang over there. I'll start moving Ulrich to the window. Because, yeah, we don't even have a better shot than that. Benito is far, far away. So let's boost him up inside the building in a minute. But what can you hit? Oh, you can hit everybody. That is interesting, because most of these guys are just, well, not in your sights, if I would take a guess. 3-6 on the officer. It's free, so why not? Ooh, 4 damage. That's really, really good. Now, I think I'm going to open the door and use the incendiary bomb with Yang. Yang, yeah. Let's open the door. Hello! And then use the incendiary bomb, 5-6. And try to keep a path open for myself. Because otherwise I'm going to be fucked. I want to keep it to the left a bit. Yeah, I have a path if I keep it like that. So incendiary bomb. Boom, indeed. It's going to hurt. Boom! Fire damage is actually really, really damaging. So, especially on soft targets such as these trooper guys. What else do we have? I still have a grenade. Well, why not A? Why not A? Jesus, come on. Give me... I can see it. See it happening. I could just blow these guys up, but I think they're gonna die from... come on, I saw it here. Yeah, there. Over here somewhere. Yeah, there we go. Yep, take care of the shield bearer's armor. Oh, I really like it better this way. That I save my my grenades for last. So that's an open shield bearer, which is really good. And then we have actually two more pistol shots, which I'm gonna use on the shield bearer to start with. And that was a miss, okay, so my second shot is 93% chance.
Shot failed to connect.
Yeah, there was 7% chance that you would miss that, but let's just try that again, and hopefully you don't... Otherwise, you're really, really blind. Yeah, thank you very much.
Well, how about that?
How about that, indeed? How many shots do we have left? If I go over here, I'm not gonna get sight of anything, probably. Ooh, we still have Jazz as well, but Jazz won't have a good position, I'm afraid. I could put him over here, and maybe he sees someone, but I think that's a very, very slim chance. Ooh, and we have Christoph still as well, so Christoph could possibly kill one of those as well. Oh no, he can kill him. I'm not gonna even... do I activate run and gun? I'm gonna see. If I can go over here... No, it's out of cover, but if I can go over here and use his gas bomb, that would be amazing. I actually wonder, can I use... No, I can't use combat protocol. Okay. So let's check. No, Jazz, not Jazz. Christoph, thank you very much. 4 to 5, so if that hits... Yeah, okay, never mind. So, poison and fire. So, goodbye, guys. Goodbye. See you in the next life. Oh. Died. They all died. And then Implacable just... Yeah, I'm gonna boost him towards the evac zone.
Whatever you say.
The closer we can get, the better. Why not, eh? And then the VIP is gonna have to... Watch out for poison. She... Oh, don't get poisoned, please. I'm just gonna put her over here just to be safe. Although we have 5 turns left, so I'm just gonna put her over here to be even more safe. Let's put Inigo over here. And I guess I'll see you guys at the evac zone. There we go.
Nessun problema. Gate clear.
And get them out of here. Nope, I clearly pressed R2 there. And evac out of there. That was pretty, pretty easy. The only thing that happened was that one shot from the turret on Yang.
Mission accomplished.
And of course, Jazz fell down the building as well. But that's not my fault. We can all agree that that was definitely not my fault. Definitely not my fault. But Vinny dealt most damage and made most attacks with his pistol shots. Because they're becoming very, very powerful. And the Mimic Beacon was most on the fire, of course. And Christoph again, as always, our runner moved the furthest. And we're here. Back at the Avenger, and let's see what the spoils of war are. Oh, I completely forgot to check out those towers. Anyway, I always forget to do that. But, 2 promotions. And Jazz got wounded for less damage, but apparently dropping from a building that was actually lower than the one he dropped down from before. Caused him to be wounded for 7 days, but I'm gonna put another engineer in the Advanced Warfare Center, so that should fix that. Benito's promotion, is that his last one? Yes, indeed. Restoration, the gremlin flies to each squad member, healing or reviving them as needed. Or capacitor discharge, and it's scrolling, so give me a second. Send the gremlin to a location where it emits a substantial electric discharge, damaging and potentially stunning all nearby units. Robotic units take more damage. That's really powerful, but I think we have enough stuff to deal with robots. So I think I'm gonna go for restoration, actually. Gremlin flies to each squad member, healing or reviving them as needed. That's really, really powerful, even because I don't think you need a medikit to do that. So yeah, I'm gonna go with that. I'm actually not really sure, but I think you don't need a medkit to actually perform that. There we go. And then Jazz, another blade ability probably? Conceal or running gun? Running gun is so powerful. I mean, conceal is also cool, so immediately enter concealment once per mission, allowing him to conceal whenever he wants to. So if we needed to sacrifice Christoph, we can use conceal to get Jazz on scouting duty. So yeah, maybe that's not such a bad idea. So let's use him as a concealer. There we go, and that's the mission. And then we got the laser sight, advanced hair trigger, and Alessia Ferrari. Ooh, she must be very fast. And that should allow us to research stuff a bit faster, even with that extra scientist. And 160 intel should have been more if I would have bothered to remember to check that security poll. Alessia Ferrari, research time decreased by 70%. God, it's coming. Yeah, it's getting really, really small, those research bonuses. Do I have an extra engineer? No, we don't. Okay, so one engineer here, one there, and then over here. We need the resistance comms, so we can't remove that. But the workshop, yeah, I'm going to lose those gremlins as well. I'm going to remove the engineer from over here, so Esmeralda. So let's empty that up. And now it's going to take a bit longer to clear the alien machinery, but we now can put her in the Advanced Warfare Center to speed up that healing, because Cedric has been in the infirmary for a very long time. And now Yang and Jazz are in there as well, and Benito is paying Jazz a visit, apparently. Let's see. I think we need to go to the bridge, yeah. Because we have those leftover supplies from the supply drop, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, yes, I know. What's all this? And a soldier. So we still have 256 supplies left there, and then we should be able to upgrade our weapons, which I really, really want. Maybe, or maybe just keep.
Now operational.
Ooh, new high priority research projects now available. Maria Kuznetsova is also now available.
Although I'm impressed with the strides we've made in infiltrating the alien psionic network, the depths of their technological advancement continue to leave us one step behind. However, with the enhanced decryption capabilities of this chamber, I'm confident we will find a great deal more information than we had previously hoped.
This is a very cool room, because...
New objective added.
It's not really the alien containment facility from XCOM Enemy Within or Enemy Unknown, but it's kind of an advanced research center, so we can use this to perform more intricate research projects. And there's also another very interesting benefit to the Shadow Chamber, which I'm going to show you in a minute. But, new objective, use the Shadow Chamber to examine the recovered Codex Brain. So, okay.
New objective added.
And then examine the recovered Black Site Vial. And I think both of those...
Fully operational. We can use its advanced decryption capabilities to analyze the Codex artifact recovered by our forces. We are fully prepared to begin our analysis of the material recovered from the... Advent Black Site, Commander.
Thank you, Tygon. So we're gonna be able to use this to do some advanced research projects, and I think both of these projects actually reduce the Avatar project timer as well. So very important chamber just for that. But I think they also... I can't do that unless I stop researching the thing I'm currently... Yeah, all research projects will be suspended. So I'm just gonna wait until the research of the powered armor is completed, so that's 9 days. So that should be fine. So that's still clear. I'm gonna put Maria Kuznetsova in there, helping the gremlins out and clearing that alien machinery, because that's where we want to build another resistance comms facility. And then we're going to start moving towards the lower row. So that's going to take the longest to clear out, but also going to give us the most supplies. And then back to the bridge, because we're still in need of supplies. Not going to fly back to Resistance HQ, so ignored all that. And now, so we still have an alien facility over here, but we need to make contact with New India to even access that area. Oh, and now the supplies are actually gone. That research thingy, that scanning thingy for the supplies is actually gone. So the only thing that's left is a soldier. Which, of course, I'm going to do then. So let's go to that soldier. Let's go check it out. 4 days, and everybody got out of the Advanced Warfare Center. I'm wondering... don't think I have any use for that extra engineer. Maybe now I do, since that's cleared out. So that gave us a lot of extra supplies. Let's build the resistance communications.
Facility construction initiated.
And then add one engineer, apparently. I can't. Okay, that's what... Okay. That was not what I wanted to do. So let's quickly check back. No, I can't add any more engineers, sadly. So that's gonna take 8 days to build. And only then can we make contact with a new area. We're also starting to get pretty low on power. But that's gonna get fixed on top of this exposed power coil. I could actually do that already, since we actually have the extra engineer.
The big risk getting inside Advent. Enough for me to believe he's loyal to our cause. There may still be a few skeptics in the movement, but we've got bigger things to worry about than a man on a screen.
I know, right, we need to expose the power coil first, so... yeah, we're probably gonna need that first. Oh, they're all busy. Wait, didn't I have an extra engineer left? Apparently I didn't. So yeah, because... oh yeah, I can remove the engineer from the Advanced Warfare Center because nobody is wounded anymore. And let's use her to expose the power coil. Or to start progress on that anyway. Because that's going to take, 30 days. Thank you very much. Let's get back to the bridge. And I won't forget to build items. So give me a second. Firefights! The ground nearby was littered with shell casings and scorched from the impact of energy weapons. While examining the seemingly desolate area, a lone veteran who had come to the scene with salvage for barter approached our squad hoping to do business. It took very little convincing for them to join our ranks. Emma Hill, a specialist. Okay. Awaiting orders in the armory. We don't have another thing to scan, so I think I'm gonna head back to Resistance HQ. Because we can't do anything else. Maybe go to the black market, but... I might actually do that, because we have a bit of intel left. Let's do that.
Avenger plotting new course.
In anticipation for our next mission, which I think might be a retaliation mission, actually.
Market is
open. So there we go, let's buy. Let's see, what do you have? All superior scope. These are some really, really awesome thingies. I think I'm gonna buy the superior scope. I'm just gonna add that to Cedric's scope. So Cedric's sniper rifle, I should say. And that's gonna be an amazing weapon. I'm actually tempted to buy the autoloader as well. I'm actually gonna do that. I'm gonna buy the superior scope and the superior autoloader. Thank you very much. Because that's just amazing. Then... what else can we do? I think it's high time we go check out our soldiers, because we have a new one. So Emma joined our squad. There we go, specialist Emma Hill, Doc. Well, Doc is fitting for... how should I promote you? 70 hack plus 20 because of the gremlin. I think another hacker, just as a backup, isn't bad. Because hacking is generally more useful than healing, but I might actually go for field medic instead of... can perform healing actions remotely. Gremlin has a single charge, field medic, equip medikits have two extra charges. Why not? Covering fire, overwatch shots can now be triggered by enemy action or threat assessment. 8 protocol now grants the target a covering overwatch shot. But it's increased by one turn. Let's just keep her aggressive. And that's pretty much Emma Hill. She actually looks pretty cool. Really cool design and a bit of the anarchy gear on top of that. So yeah, welcome to the squad, Emma. So Cedric's is still shaken actually. So this next mission should help him out with that. Let's customize your weapon. And remove the normal scope for the superior scope. That should be fine. Yep. There we go. And an advanced autoloader. I'm just going to keep that. Because a superior autoloader is going to be handier for somebody else. Because I think I want to give Vinny the superior autoloader. Although with the pistol he doesn't really need one. I think most of them actually have an autoloader already. Maybe Ulrich, do you have an autoloader? I don't remember. Advanced expanded magazine and a stock. So the advanced expanded magazine could do nicely with an autoloader. Although, you don't really fire that much for now. So I'm just gonna keep that superior autoloader in the bag. I'm just not gonna do anything with it for now. Okay, and then we might actually go to engineering for a bit build those plasma rifles. There's nothing else, right? Oh, and a storm gun, of course. So storm gun first. So that upgrades everybody's shotgun. We usually use more shotguns than rifles. But plasma rifles, they're actually really, really expensive, and I don't know if I want to upgrade them just yet. I'm going to if the next mission is the retaliation mission, but we're going to see about that in a second. Yeah. Don't start talking if I go to the bridge immediately with the quick button. So let's go to Resistance HQ. Gaining intel is always handy. 220 supplies for an engineer. No, thank you. There we go, guerrilla operations. Review our targets.
We've had the shadow chamber running the numbers. These are the tactical projections for our next field operation.
There we go. The shadow chamber's extra ability is that we now see what enemies will spawn on the mission that we're going to select. So 9 enemies. Enemy unknown, so might actually be a new enemy type. Viper, elite officer, elite shield bearer, advent mech, heavy lancer, and elite trooper. So not that many robotic enemies on this one. Rapid response guarantees reinforcements on all guerrilla operations. Viper rounds or the hidden event. So I think I'm gonna go for East Asia. So difficult, only 9 enemies, but an enemy unknown, and I think I know what that's going to be. So that's why I'm probably gonna keep Vinny in the squad as well. So let's go to East Asia. So let's check out our squad. We're gonna make a few changes. I'm not gonna use Emma Hill just yet, because, well, she's not one of the character pool. So I'm gonna add Cedric back in. And then, actually, this is pretty nice. So we have, do we need to hack anything? No, but the Skilljack might be handy. But Hugh needs some experience as well. I'm hesitating between two specialists or two grenadiers. So we're moving Hugh again in favor of, but Benito is max level right now, so I might actually remove Benito for this mission and just go with Jazz again. Oh no, not Jazz. Yang. Just to use those extra grenades. Although Jazz's sword attacks might actually be handy as well, but I'm trying to level up everybody to an equal level. I am going to clear items again, so make utility items available, and then give Christophe the Mimic Beacon again instead of the gas bomb, although that gas bomb just saved our lives in the last episode. Well, the last mission. So this episode, Jesus Christ. And then the gas bomb that Hugh is carrying, I'm gonna swap that out for the Skulljack. So that should allow him to Skulljack some enemies as well, even though Benito is not on the premises. And then I might actually swap out the... No, I'm gonna keep the EMP bomb, that might just come in handy. And then we have... I'm just gonna edit Vinny and give the spider suit back to Cedric. There we go. So Vinny will be our sniper on the ground, and then Cedric will be our sniper up top. So spider suit. And do we have anything fancy for you? Gas bombs, maybe. I like a bit more destruction, so why not? And with the Vipers on this mission, we might as well not bother with the gas bombs. So incendiary and normal grenades, one EMP bomb, mimic beacon, a bunch of nice ammo, and of course the Skulljack is gonna, hack the hidden resistance computer. Hopefully Hugh can do that, but I have all the confidence in him, but that will have to wait until next episode, because I'm gonna take, of course, a little break. So thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to like it right here on YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I'd really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thanks again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video series. Goodbye!